Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A new paper published by an MIT physicist claims to theoretically prove that so-called quantum entanglement, or two particles each seemingly occupying multiple states simultaneously, gives rise to a wormhole, which allows particles to communicate through a so-called gravitational tunnel. This theory follows from a paper published earlier this year, which suggests that when two black holes become entangled, then are pulled apart, a wormhole is created which connects the black holes. The reasoning in these papers follows from a purely mathematical approach to physics and cosmology. In this two-part presentation, physicist Wal Thornhill examines just how reliable this approach is at describing how the universe actually works.
A glaring example of the irrational is to be seen in a recent Science Daily report titled, "You Can't Get Entangled Without a Wormhole," which refers to papers by Julian Sonner, a senior postdoc in MIT's Lab for Nuclear Science and Center for Theoretical Physics, and a related paper by Kristen Jensen of the University of Victoria and Andreas Karsh of the University of Washington. The article says that essentially, entanglement involves two particles, each occupying multiple states at once, a condition referred to as superposition. For example, both particles may simultaneously spin clockwise and counterclockwise, but neither has a definite state until one is measured, causing the other particle to instantly assume a corresponding state. The resulting correlations between the particles are preserved, even if they reside on opposite ends of the universe. End of quote. Now, the word entanglement is a euphemism to hide the fact that the physical connection is unknown. So all that follows isn't physics, it's mystification. The indeterminacy of states also means we are not dealing with physics, which relies on being able to determine the state of the system being observed. From a real physicist's point of view, the most telling experimental fact is that the connection between two entangled particles is instantaneous, even if they reside on opposite ends of the universe. So the article asks the question, but what enables particles to communicate instantaneously and seemingly faster than the speed of light over such distances? The simple classical physics answer is that the connection between the two particles is not via a slow transverse electromagnetic wave. Instead, it's the same kind of connection that we observe between the planets and the sun, that is, gravity. Newton's law of gravity does not include time. The force of gravity acts instantaneously. Now, the electric universe explains that gravity itself is a form of the electric force that operates upon neutral bodies by distorting the subatomic charged particles within those bodies to form tiny, weak electric dipoles. This simple model explains why gravity is such a weak force, because subatomic particles are infinitesimally small, and also why you can't easily shield from gravity, because all of the subatomic particles participate, whether it's a conductor or a non-conductor, whatever it's made from. Importantly, though, gravity on the cosmic scale allows us to see that the direct electric force between particles operates instantly. The spookiness and non-locality of quantum phenomena can be understood both physically and in meaningful language. Entanglement, then, is simply an electrical resonance between two subatomic particles, each comprised of an identical resonant system of orbiting charged subparticles. In other words, it's a repeated pattern, like an atom within an atom. The instantaneous connection maintains the resonance or entanglement between the particles regardless of their relative movement or distance apart. Because the connection is instantaneous, there is no Doppler shift detuning or anything like that. The two particles remain in communication. This model that separates the phenomenon of electromagnetic waves in a medium from the direct longitudinal connection between all matter in the universe, that is the electrical connection, opens up new insights for physicists. For example, physicists attempt to isolate their experiment from outside influences, including the observer. But in our electric universe, there is no isolated system. The observer is a part of the experiment, whether he likes it or not, and as discovered in so-called weird quantum experiments. Contrast this simple explanation with the meaningless language of the report, and I quote, "Earlier this year, physicists proposed an answer in the form of wormholes or gravitational tunnels. The group showed that by creating two entangled black holes, then pulling them apart, they formed a wormhole, essentially a shortcut through the universe, connecting the distant black holes. Now, black holes are a mathematical mistake equivalent to the school mathematics howler of dividing by zero to get infinity. Gravity is weaker than the electric force by a factor of 1,000 billion, 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 billion times. Now, that's as close to zero as you can get. So using gravity to explain the concentrated energy sources observed at the centers of galaxies, and calling them black holes, is bound to give you answers that make no physical sense. The wormholes are a geometric construct in more than three dimensions, so they have nothing to do with the real space that physicists, engineers, and you and I have to deal with. But the article continues. Now an MIT physicist has found that, looking through the lens of string theory, the creation of two entangled quarks, the building blocks of matter, simultaneously give rise to a wormhole connecting the pair. That's the end of the quote. But string theory is, according to Peter Woit, not even wrong. The questions that need to be answered by this piece of whimsy are both endless and pointless. Pointless because no one knows what a quark is, nor how matter can warp space to form a hole across the universe, or even what that means, nor how that effect can be instantaneous. Space is merely a concept of location in three dimensions. How do you warp a concept? But the article goes on. The theoretical results bolster the relatively new and exciting idea that the laws of gravity holding together the universe may not be fundamental, but arise from something else, quantum entanglement. That's hardly a breakthrough when you don't understand quantum entanglement. You'll notice that modern physics is in the business of complicating things beyond comprehension, inventing new particles and forces in the hope of a Nobel Prize. It is not the way classical physics was done. Classical physics, until the beginning of the 20th century, was in the business of simplifying particles and forces. There was a strong intuitive feel on the part of leading scientists then that gravity is simply an electrical force of some description, like the forces between atoms that form our Earth and everything on it. That's the conclusion of the electric universe based on all the new evidence since then. The article says, of course, there appears to be a major barrier to reconciling quantum mechanics and general relativity. For years, physicists have tried to come up with a theory of quantum gravity to marry the two fields. You'll notice that the standard picture of a black hole or gravitational object in space is represented as a funnel in space-time, usually with an object like, in the Earth's case, the moon perched on the edge of the funnel. With the idea being that the moon, instead of traversing a straight line in space, follows the curve of the funnel. However, the very image itself gives a false picture because we just assume that this gravitational well or funnel has gravity pulling from underneath to draw the object down into the funnel. But this is using gravity to explain gravity. It's a circular argument, and the image is quite misleading. An object perched on the surface of this funnel, if gravity were not pulling it down, would remain fixed on that funnel. It would have no force tending to move it downwards or sideways or upwards. It would remain exactly where it is. But it's plain to see that general relativity never explained gravity. It merely described its effect in a geometry that has no reality. And quantum mechanics is a recipe book with no understanding of the ingredients or how they interact. As a result, the rest of the article is appalling nonsense headlined, Tunneling to the Fifth Dimension. It's only necessary to highlight the meaningless language to show the ideas expressed are imaginary. For example, two entangled black holes forgets that the mathematics of black hole theory allows only a single black hole in an empty universe. The Newtonian principle of superposition of gravitating objects doesn't apply to general relativity. There can never be a second black hole to get entangled. The theorists invoke a wormhole, a tunnel through space-time, produced by pulling two black holes apart. Hyphenating the words space and time to produce a fourth dimension is physically meaningless. Mathematicians use the word dimension to mean a degree of freedom in their equations. There are only three physical dimensions in space, which are measured by length and direction. Time has no length or direction. You can't point in the direction of time. Time has no arrow. Joining space and time has no physical significance. So you cannot produce physical wormholes in space. It is pure science fiction. One of the authors, Sonner, applied this thinking to quarks, the theoretical subatomic building blocks of matter. And I quote, "To see what emerges from two entangled quarks, he first generated quarks using the Schwinger effect, a concept in quantum theory that enables one to create particles out of nothing." End of quote. Here we see mathematicians resorting to dismissal of a principle of physics that you cannot perform a creation miracle. It's not scientific. The author Douglas Adams in The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy parodied this sleight of hand mercilessly when Zaphod Beeblebrock used an infinite improbability drive to rescue Ford Prefect and Arthur Dent in deep space. Particle physicists have been using the infinite improbability principle since the inception of quantum theory. As is well known, Einstein hated the idea. He's reported to have said, "God doesn't throw dice." He was right. As soon as you disconnect cause from effect, you are not doing science. Another quote from the article. Sonner mapped the entangled quarks onto a four-dimensional space, considered a representation of space-time. In contrast, gravity is thought to exist in the next dimension as, according to Einstein's laws, it acts to bend and shape space-time, thereby existing in the fifth dimension. End of quote. There is no four-dimensional space. There is no physical fifth dimension. Gravity is not explained by general relativity. It is merely described in a limited and unreal geometric way. It is not shown how imaginary four-dimensional space can be warped. Cause and effect are disconnected. It just ain't science. It's merely mathematics. The article finally leaves all common sense and logic far behind. And I quote, "To see what geometry may emerge in the fifth dimension from entangled quarks in the fourth, Sonner employed holographic duality, a concept in string theory. While a hologram is a two-dimensional object, it contains all the information necessary to represent a three-dimensional view. Essentially, holographic duality is a way to derive a more complex dimension from the next lowest dimension." End of quote. This is total rubbish. There is no two-dimensional object. All objects are three-dimensional, so there can be no information held in two dimensions. Real objects and information can only occupy three dimensions. Coming back to the Space News report, the black hole is an alleged product of Einstein's theory of gravitation, but so is the wormhole between the two supposed black holes. It's known as an Einstein-Rosen bridge. But then the wormhole is used and related to the two black holes to define gravitation. Gravity emerges from the more fundamental phenomenon of entangled black holes, the article says. But this argument is simply a circular argument, and so it is nonsense.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.